Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays, the Binding of Isaac Rebirth hard mode runs. There is, no question. There's only one character. We've actually made pretty good progress, you gotta admit. I thought that I was shitting the bed, but we've done a pretty good job of at least beating Mom's heart on all of these, characters. But we do, we have to play as Eve, finally. And I'm not, you know, I say it with a little bit of a sigh. JTLC, zero, VGR. I say it with a little bit of a sigh, but the truth of the story is that I don't mind playing as Eve. Whore of Babylon has some... I hate this room. This is like... There's so many room variations in Rebirth that I haven't really had a chance to be like, oh, this fucking room, very often. But this fucking room, man. I hate it. Oh, that champion. Cool it, thank you. That champion actually dropped a key for us, which is rare on hard mode, to get champions that actually drop items. There is a Tinted Rock up here. I would love to be able to... Maybe have the capabilities to pick up a bomb. The problem with this room is just that it takes 100 years, and you like this is not one of those Isaac rooms where you can kind of sit back and you know just kind of mindlessly fire at them and dodge every now and then. Like there's some real kind of active thought that has to go into this room. We've handled it pretty well, and we got a key, and there's a bomb over there that we can't take advantage of course. But hey. Let's, now that we've cleared that out, move along here. The ideal, for me, the ideal Eve run is, I don't give a shit if we get HP on this floor, just allow me to get down to one red heart on the next floor via a deal with the devil by giving me a good offensive or defensive item. So, like, next floor, a deal that lets us get down to one heart or zero, that gives us Mom's Knife, Brimstone, the Nail, Satanic Bible, Dark Bum, probably Ceremonial Robes. What I'm getting at right now, I'm very happy to have Odd Mushroom in our item room, yet again. But what I'm getting at is basically an item that lets us get low on HP, but compensates us either with damage or with the ability to kind of claw back a different kind of HP from that. Satanic Bible and the Nail, obviously, with Spirit Hearts and the Black Hearts, and Dark Bum similarly, albeit in a different kind of mechanism. Mechanism. You get the idea. Good stuff so far. Oh, I forgot that even though we haven't taken damage, we're not at full HP. That's okay. We're gonna do a little bit of further exploration here. There's another big room. I don't know if big rooms are more likely to spawn on hard mode. To be honest with you, I don't even know if it necessarily feels like that. It would be easy enough for me to say like, yeah, that's totally what it is. What are you dancing about, Kate? Your butt hurts. That was not what I was expecting there. I thought it was, that looked like a happy dance out of my peripheral vision, but turns out it's actually the dance of anal destruction. you can't hear it, but she laughed in the other room. Anyway, we're gonna move on here. I would love to get a bomb because that Tinted Rock is kind of taunting me from the other room. What I will say is that I have been spoiled a little bit. You know, on the last run, we were Judas. That was not very good. On the last run, we were Judas, which meant that we, I was gonna say, prove yourself useful for once in this godforsaken life. We didn't really have to worry about, deals with the devil. Deals with the devil just came naturally to us, which is fantastic. Unfortunately, we're not in the same position this time. We're gonna need to actually preserve our, ability to get a deal with the devil. So this one guy has got, like, a little bit of a dark tint going on, which means he might explode into bombs if he dies. So I was kind of hoping that maybe he would walk his way up here. Unfortunately, he refuses to. Oh, you know what? No, he might not even explode. He didn't explode. Okay, maybe bombs from our boss, the Bang the Bang Dicky. I don't know. We'll see. For now, Larry Jr., you know what? I'm almost tempted to say that apart from the haunt, well, you can only get the haunt on, Cellar. Larry Jr. might be the most difficult basement boss with the exception of Gurglings. Now, there are some situations in which Larry Jr. is easier than other bosses. If you have, piercing shots of any kind, including, you know, Brimstone or Mom's Knife, then Larry Jr. is, like, the easiest boss you could possibly face in this area. But if you don't, you know, he's got a decent amount of HP, and he's relatively difficult to dodge compared to something like Monstro or, you know, Gemini. But we actually made it happen, and that feels good. We almost didn't make it happen there. It doesn't really matter if we get hit at this point, because again, no deal with the devil, but should very much like to be able to access it regardless. Damage upgrade is great. We already got our HP upgraded on this floor, so that's effectively 2 HP that we've garnered for ourselves. Let's head down to the next floor. And on the next floor, we do have keys. That feels great. No bombs. Our item room's right here. This is something I was excited about the opportunity of. Let's hopefully get something good. And there's our bomb. So, oh, Parasite's pretty sweet and also has cool synergies. So I don't think Parasite is like the greatest item in the game or anything like that, but it is a neat item. And that's enough for me for the most part. Makes it a little easier to kill poop. What we need is like Cricket's body now. We already have Parasite, then we get Cricket's body, and we just get like even further and further. Ooh. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Oh, I got very lucky. Further and further divisions. Stop spawning bombs, you big garbage factory. You are a factory that literally just makes trash. That is your contribution to this world. Does that make you feel good about yourself, Ultra Pride? Because it freaking shouldn't. I mean, we're all garbage factories if you want to get technical about it, but the Stirrer's card. We'll use that on the next floor to save a key. Could also use it to like teleport out of our curse room or something like that, but so we could trade a bomb for one key, but we'll have to walk across the spikes to get it. I think I may say no to that opportunity. Very generous of you, game. Bomb for a key and some damage. Honestly, I mean that half facetiously, but there are some situations in which I would gladly take a little bit of red heart damage to trade a bomb for a key. This is not one of them, though. Oh my god, I can't believe that spider navigated the gauntlet, which I threw out to deal with it. That was a little scary. Honestly, these spiders, they're tricksters. You think you got them on the ropes, but you rarely have them as roped off as you'd think you would. It's good. Yeah, just basically, I'm not trying to be too aggressive, because any damage that I can do to them when they're far away is free damage. I love the concept of free damage. Now, it's a little tempting to jump into our... Oh my god. It's a little tempting to jump into our shop there and try to pick up a spirit heart or something, but I'm gonna say no to that. Oh, god damn it. There probably goes our deal with the devil chance there, but my thinking was, you know, if you go to the shop, you have a pretty good chance to pick up... yep, there we go. Pretty good chance to pick up a spirit heart. Fuck the deal with the devil. We should just be concerned about this run ending. Are you seeing this horse fucking hockey? Okay, you know the deal. Watch out for the brimstone tail. Pretty lucky to also be in a situation where Dead Bird will do some damage. Oh no. Watch out for the brimstone tail. Dead Bird, finish the job, dog. Okay, we're alive. Now I think we have to go to the shop, as much as I don't want to. Because we need red hearts. And there is a red heart for sale. We're better off probably buying a spirit heart. So we'll do that, because it does keep us in the Whore of Babylon state. And we picked up another damage upgrade, so even though we didn't get a deal with the devil, I am excited. Because every damage upgrade, you know, it helps, dog. It means the world to me. We're not going to go to our curse room, because that's potentially suicidal. This is a tough one. It's amazing how differently this run would have gone if we had just been fighting, like, Monstro, for example. But oh well. We'll use our Stars card quickly, just to get it started. You know, every advantage that you can get is advantageous. Attack Fly is fine. Let's start, hopefully, farming up some red hearts and not taking damage ourselves. You know, with the Parasite, it also seems like every damage upgrade kind of makes your shots... The ricochets of your shots do even more damage, so, seems like a very nice kind of thing to make a Parasite even a little bit more effective than it already is. Our item rooms have been pretty dang okay thus far. And I can't even say that this run is a problem yet. But it could be in the future. If we lose the Spirit Heart, we're in a very, very dire spot. But if we keep the Spirit Heart, we could actually get a deal with the devil on this floor. And who knows what kind of great discoveries await us after that, you know? Get a deal with the devil. maybe ceremonial robes or something like that. Extra damage, plus it gives us a better chance to permanently stay in the Horror Babylon state. Which I'm realizing is pretty, maybe not integral to our success, but is one avenue for success that, oh, that's bad. There's one avenue for success that we, you know, would be wise to explore. I'm pulling out all the stops right now. Our secret room is not going to be adjacent to one of these rooms. You gotta watch out for these guys, as you may have noticed. Now, I would rather pick up a red heart. I was just going to say, I would rather get out of our Whore of Babylon state and take the less damage hit on the chin, basically. But be much more likely to actually survive. Yeah, that's it. Get in the fuck corridor here. Sometimes people ask me, what does a fuck corridor look like? You got it, right there, man. Red hearts, please. I'm very displeased with the damage that I took there. Okay, we can take that, and it actually won't take us out of Horror Babylon state. As Eve, you can stay at one heart. It's nice, but that doesn't really matter, because the enemies on this room could still kill us. But this is like your ideal, you know? You want to be at one full red heart as Eve. Oh, if we just hit that second shot. Oh my god! I don't know if my heart can take this. I'm just gonna be quiet for a second, which is more of a challenge for me than you might expect. It's more of a challenge than not taking damage here, is not saying anything. Like, see, I'm already saying shit right now, and I should just be shutting my mouth. Yeah, okay. Dare we? I think we dare. Okay. Double Gertie Jr. This is like the worst case scenario for me. Are you seeing this? The greatest dodges of all time. This is like the most difficult boss for me to avoid. I think they might have nerfed it a little bit, but this will give me a spirit heart. And maybe a deal with the devil? No deal with the devil, but we got HP anyway. Man, okay, we're incredibly lucky to be alive at this point. Yeah, I'm totally fine fighting Larry Jr. again, don't get me wrong. This is... It's been a bit harrowing. We're not in a bad position. Like, we've gotten so many kind of vanilla damage upgrades. Like, vanilla that, meaning, didn't require a, yeah, I think this will be our secret room. Didn't require, deal with the devil. So, we're pretty lucky in that regard. I think we could probably justify this. I think we'll look for, a second secret room down here as well. Maybe try, like, here. Alright, well, it's not so bad. Yeah, like, we could still easily make this run work, at least beat Mom's heart with it, but we're just in a position where, I don't know, it could easily go either way. It's a much more variable run than the average in Rebirth, that's for sure. Like, usually you're like, okay, I've got these items, I'm in a good position. On this run, it's really like, the difference between this being an amazing run and a totally awful run are not that large. It's basically... It comes down less to the actual items and more to my play. If I play well, this run has the potential to have a huge upside. If I play terribly, this run, you know, it doesn't. Good stuff. Gotta remember, our damage is not high enough that I should even entertain the thought of playing chicken with these guys. This seems like a pretty ideal, like Parasite seems like a pretty ideal item to fight those ding-dongs. Because, even if we miss, we hit. Which is a luxury choice for us. Unfortunately, we cannot access our item room, nor can we access our shop, nor can we even access our secret room, unless we get some kind of consumables in the near future. Which would be nice, by the way, in case you're asking, or you're trying to fish for something to get me for Christmas game, a key would not be the worst idea. It's been two floors without one now. We were able to go to the shop, or sorry, the item room on our last floor because we had a stars card. That's the other thing you get me, is a stars card. That would also be worthwhile. Alright, just no consumables at all. That's fine too, I guess. Beggars can't be choosers. Well, you know, if you're not giving me shit, I guess I'll at least offer what I would like to have. Please don't drop something over there. Thought we glitched out the game for a minute. Alright, this is like our perfect storm in a good way. All we gotta do, not take damage against these guys, secure a deal with the devil, get a good item. And if we get like the crate from this, this would be awesome as well, but it's like an easy boss. Oh my god, we actually did get the box. I call it the crate, whatever. You get the idea. Let's pick up the poop and then do that and this. What's better, petrified poop or counterfeit penny? That gives us invincibility for one room. I know we had Mom's Knife on the last run. We're taking it again. It doesn't show up all that often, and I like it. Range up. What gives us more, what's more beneficial, counterfeit penny or the petrified poop? I honestly think it's petrified poop. Counterfeit penny, if you could take both of them at the same time, that would be some unparalleled kind of synergy between trinkets, but I think petrified poop is more likely to give you more money. So yeah, we botched our synergy a little bit, you know? We don't have little knives that shoot out from the parasite every time it lands. But these runs are largely about life and death. So I don't feel bad about taking Mom's Knife. And you know, my New Year's resolution? This is your typical Canadian New Year's resolution. I'm gonna stop apologizing so much for doing what I want to do, right? I gotta be true to myself. I wonder if we can... no. I was thinking if we could bomb our way into the shop via a secret room, but it doesn't look like it. If you're wondering what, like, my secret room methodology is, by the way, it really seems, and I haven't confirmed nor denied this, but I think I saw a post about it on the subreddit as well. It really seems like... Man, I really should have taken Gimpy so I could be in the permanent, Horror of Babylon state, but it seems like, you... cannot have a secret room in a cation that's, like, unable to be bombed. Alright, that's a good pill. Which means, like, if there's a gap, like, this, on the far left side here, you might say, well, it's adjacent to three rooms, maybe we could put our secret room there, but I don't think it can be there. Thank you for the spirit heart. Because there's a gap that is impossible to traverse unless you can fly. Which makes it actually much easier than it may at first glance look to find secret rooms. That seems like a decent enough trade for me. I don't think that would have found the secret room anyway. Just doing some standard exploration right now. I would very much love, by the way, to go back to our deal with the devil. I just wasn't thinking straight. I was like, Mom's Knife, yeah, we'll take it. Gimpy, is it worth it? I think most of the time Gimpy's not worth it, but Gimpy is effectively a temporary damage upgrade for us. Temporary until we pick up another HP upgrade. Well, I wish that we had a bomb. That's okay. So in that case, Gimpy for one red heart is basically like getting Whore of Babylon plus Gimpy for one red heart, which is a great deal. Alas, and alack. Hopefully we can go back. I have to take it. I have heard that Tiny Planet Mom's Knife is a bit of a cumbersome choice. The worst case scenario of this is that we just use it as a melee weapon, which is not going to be the way I want to handle things. But I know that Nick is not a big fan of the way this item works, but you know, I said the most important thing for us here is to win. But if we can't win while doing some stupid stuff, what does it matter, right? I want to do some stupid stuff here. And this is, oh, we do get to go back, thank you. This is some stupid stuff. Alright. I suppose we could have tried to use the rune here as well, but I don't really want the razor blade. I'd rather keep this rune for, you know, maybe a late game boss fight that we do want to just use our melee weapon on. Who knows how cumbersome this is going to be in the future. Curse of Darkness. Don't get your hopes up about a boss trap room. That's key! Alright. That's key. Pretty useful on a run like this. This is not going so well right now. I'll be the first to admit, okay? My hope was that I would be able to just kind of like make this work. We're turning the knife as soon as we get it in there. But like I thought we would be able to stand in the center of the room and just go like woo, and then that would take care of anything. It's not working that way thus far. Like, I thought that would... Oh, it did do it, technically. This is... You know, I agree with Nick. This is a prohibitive way to use this item. A lot of the complaints about items like Tiny Planet, I'm like, ah, you just hate fun. This one, like, this affects you, man. You go ahead there, Deadbird. This might actually ruin this run, but I know I took a lot of damage there. I'm still gonna do my damnedest to make this work. I'm not gonna give up. It is very hard to hit enemies, though. You're funny, Demon Judgment. Yeah. That was not good. Thank you, Gimpy. It really seems like melee might be the way to go here. Like, run into a room, take a shot at it, then melee the shit out of everything. Well, what you can also do is this ye old Tiny Planet strategy.jpg, and, you know, it still seems to help to... Oh, thanks a lot. I saw fucking Mathis tweet, and he tweeted, I could message Northern Lion and slow down his game in Rebirth right now, but I don't want to do it because I'll be an asshole. And then I'm pretty sure that people were just like, be an asshole. And he's like, fine, I have a reason to be an asshole now. I'm just going to delete him. Sign out of Skype when you play Isaac. You should know better. You're the only douchebag that messages me. That's like saying, lock your front door. Someone might rob you. You are that someone. Alright, sign out. Hey, you better lock your car door. Someone might steal your car stereo. By the way, I stole your car stereo. I was just trying to protect you from assholes, though, because I'm not an asshole. Look at this guy. Alright, I thought that might hit. This is one of the enemies you don't want to use melee range against. That didn't hit somehow? Find that a little hard to believe. If the hitbox actually was like what it looked like, it might not be so bad. But it's not, so it is. Man, this is... I really thought what would happen is you'd get like a knife that kind of spins around you in a circle, not this weird... This weird... Come on, though. Oh my Atlanta. And then, okay. This time, though. That should have hit, as far as I'm concerned. Thank fucking Christ. This is real bad. It is funny, though. I'll give it that. It's got the humor element working out in its favor. I wonder if you got like Monstro's lung with this. What I think is that you should send out like a huge like army of knives. What would probably end up happening is that it would just take a long time to charge. So all right, here's my new strategy. Please die. Not so good. Here's my new strategy. You stand where you would normally stand to hit with Tiny Planet. Which is tedious in and of itself. But then you fire in the opposite direction. And you gotta be a little bit more vigilant. You know, I'm that guy. I'm the guy who's like, you don't like cursed die, you just gotta learn how to use it. You don't like blah blah blah, you just gotta learn how to use it. At least that's the image that I've been showing here. Sure, Leech will be very helpful for us, actually. So I want to be the guy that's like, you know, I don't think this is ever going to be good. I don't think you would ever get this combination and say like, you know, this is a better choice than just having Mom's knife by default. But if you find yourself in this position, I want you to be able to look at this video and say like, this is my guide to how to actually succeed on this run. So what's the other thing I'm doing here? It seems like if you have the choice, if you can stand like, directly lower and left of the enemies and then fire to the left, you can do a pretty reasonable job of hitting them. I really, really hope we get like a deal with the devil option for like Satanic Bible. If we don't, we're gonna be in a hard spot HP wise. That's bad. That is not good. Alright, well, excuse me, Tomo. I'm gonna need you to F off a little bit, please. I'm sorry, buddy. I shouldn't use that kind of language. I'm ornery right now. Dad's key also found our secret room. I didn't even know that could happen. Compass. Give you some cash right here. Might as well. I think we have to use the rune on this room. Maybe not, but probably. Red Mom, please. Oh, we're not on that floor yet. Okay. Well, the adversary's not so bad. The problem with the adversary is, you have to keep moving. And keeping moving is, like, the exact opposite of what I want to do in order to do damage consistently. Like, I gotta get... Okay, that was alright. The melee range stuff seems okay. Growth hormones, what do we got here? Yeah, sure, give me a lump of coal. That'd be beautiful. That's exactly what I need right now. Yeah, great choice there. Krampus' head. I think we gotta take that instead of Dad's key, because it gives us the extra damage. Like... Man, this is a... Don't take Tiny Plant. With Mom's knife. I'll just say it. I was wrong. There's still outs for us. You know, we're not dead yet. Some cash, I appreciate. Kind of wish we had counted a penny. I shouldn't have donated, because, again, I just thought we were on the last floor. It's like the ultimate defense against this is if you just stand, like, directly beside me and I can't get any lower. I'm starting to get the hang of it, though. You can see it. You're getting a little scared, aren't you? You're like, oh, shit, this guy's going to pull it off. This guy's going to beat Mom's heart, at least. Maybe you're saying this motherfucker has no chance. Either of those could conceivably be correct. That's it, right? Yeah, okay. Still have this algae's rune. I hate that shit. That should have hit, as far as I'm concerned. Now, in spite of only having one HP, we really have to protect it. Mobile enemies are just the worst for us right now. Leech. I'm so happy that we got Leech, at least. If he could target an enemy, that'd be even better, but, you know, I'm not gonna shit on him here. He's trying. Keep it up, though. Yeah, nice. Alright, mini-boss. You never know, right? This could be gluttony. And by the way, if you're pissed that I got rid of Dad's key to take Krampus's head, there's no way I'm fighting Mega Satan on this run. Now, Dad's key can be good as well. You know, it lets you get into that boss rush room and then get out and take an item. That's super good. I'll just admit that, but... Don't love that I had to do that, but... I don't think it was an advisable choice for us regardless. I think we had to take Krampus's head for the ability to basically clear out once every three rooms by itself. I'll take it. The HP is more important than the damage bonus at this point. Remember, what's the most important thing? Beat Mom's heart. Feel like a lot of the negativity surrounding item combinations in Isaac comes down to giving up. You know? People, they think Isaac runs are like, an endless upswing, right? Like, you just constantly get better and better and better and better and better the more items you get. And that's, you know, that's how a lot of these runs go. And I guess if you were, like, specifically trying to win only, that's how you'd... Oh, man, that was kind of bad. That's how you'd want your run to go. But, I don't know, man. I kind of embrace the idea that some Isaac runs, you know, they're kind of like life itself, you know? There's gonna be ups, there's gonna be downs, there's gonna be up to sundown, see where the bad guys are to be found and make them lay down. I don't like the idea of fighting Pim. There we go. Too easy. I think this is the way you have to do it here. You know, when Mom's Knife fires in a straight line, it makes it very easy to do damage to Pim. When Mom's Knife fires in a circle, there's no way we're doing, like, damage to multiple segments. It's bloody lust. Man, that's actually pretty good. This run could be amazing. If only some things were slightly different. Okay, that is one of the rare situations where that actually worked out quite nicely for us. That room is too easy. Alright, Zambros. This has effectively become a challenge run where most of the time we're just going to be using melee Mom's Knife. Which is a problem for many enemies. And a big reason why I'm saving Krampus's head for use on the boss fight. Don't see any deal with the devil, or tinted rocks there. It's regular Mom. I think that was okay. That's what I was waiting for right there, is like multiple bodily segments to be open at the same time. Oh, come on. This should do it, this should do it. Yes! Too easy. And we didn't even have to use our rune. But we, like, probably should immediately on the next floor, unless we find a red heart right away. Curse of Dankness! I had to. If possible, we should really just chill out and let Leech do some damage here. Can it get this enemy? I probably could have. Because I needed the lifesteal, man. We're probably gonna die to these bullshit enemies. That makes me so mad. Well, it was a ridiculous run. I had fun with it regardless. Now we know. Tiny Planet plus Mom's Knife is bad. Like, very, very bad. Thanks for watching, though. If you did enjoy the run, click the like button. Helps a lot. We'll be back as even the next run, just because this run didn't really get a chance to get off the ground. If you enjoyed it, click the like button. Subscribe. Helps out a lot. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.